Today on the BRS TV 52 FAQ, should you mix your kelk? Hi, I'm RT, your host of BRS TV's 52 FAQ. Today we're answering K-Mam's question. You mentioned that we should not stir the solution after it's been mixed initially, but certain companies like Two Little Fishies have stirrers that work with ATO, which will stir the solution once ATO is on. This is a pretty common question, and at face value, it's absolutely confusing because almost all the advice out there tells you after you mix the kelk in fresh water once, leave it sit and do not mix it again. However, all the kelk washer reactors out there do that very thing, constantly mix the solution or at least do so many times a day. The answer lies within how the kelk washer is implemented in the aquarium, which in a vast majority of cases is mixed in a container and slowly dripped into the tank or added by an auto top-off. When using an auto top-off or DIY dripper, the kelk washer or calcium hydroxide powder should be thoroughly mixed with fresh water once and once only, and then sealed with a lid on the container to limit gas exchange. Mixing it the first time allows the calcium hydroxide to fully dissolve into a solution of ionized calcium and hydroxide ions. Once it's fully mixed, it's often referred to as a fully saturated solution, meaning there's as many calcium and hydroxide ions dissolved in the water as there ever can be. After that, mixing it won't make any additional kelk washer dissolve into the solution. In fact, the opposite will happen. When you mix it, you add atmospheric carbon dioxide into the solution from the surrounding air in the room. When the CO2 enters the solution, it reacts with the hydroxide in the water to form carbonate, and in turn reacts with the calcium to precipitate out calcium carbonate and reduces the available calcium and carbonate in the solution so it's no longer fully saturated. Simply put, mixing doesn't make the solution more concentrated, it potentially makes it less potent, and it needlessly wastes raw material. Best thing you can do is put a lid on the container and leave it alone. It doesn't need to be a hermetically sealed lid, just one that limits the amount of fresh air inside the container. In fact, when left alone, the saturated kelk solution will form a crust on the surface, which essentially protects it from carbon dioxide exposure. Okay, so why do all the reactors mix it constantly or several times a day then? The answer to that is fairly simple. They're all small containers which are constantly fed new fresh water. With the previous solution, you're often mixing up enough fresh water for anywhere from an entire day to a week or even a month. With most kelk reactors, they only hold enough water for only a portion of the day, and the nature of their design is they feed the saturated kelk washer solution into the tank by pumping fresh water into the bottom of the reactor, which forces saturated kelk water out of the top. Meaning that fresh water that enters the bottom does need to be mixed. Since there's no air inside the reactor, mixing it also won't cause precipitation issues or dilute the potency due to CO2. One note, the saturated kelk solution is fairly clear, and that's what you want to dose. The milky white solution is what we commonly refer to as a kelk slurry. This slurry contains not only saturated kelk solution, but also undissolved or suspended calcium hydroxide particles. This slurry is way too potent to dose to the tank, and if you do, the pH swing will be immediate and very large. We strongly recommend against dosing the slurry to the aquarium. Open and honest, I have a hard time recommending kelk reactors in most cases. In theory, they'll keep the solution 100% saturated, but a container with a tight-fitting lid performs almost as well without the expense or hassle. Some reefers believe they save space, but you still need a container to hold the fresh water, so you're actually losing space when you add the reactor. Plus, it's just another piece of equipment which needs to be maintained and can fail. It's been our experience that simple and reliable is what produces long-term successful reef tanks. That being said, some of us are gear junkies, and knowing the mixture is 100% saturated to the max is important, so we do have some advice on selecting a proper kelk washer reactor. There are basically two types, mixers and stirrers. The mixers will turn on a pump for a few minutes to periodically mix the kelk into a slurry, and then turn it off to let the particles settle out, leaving only the saturated kelk washer solution behind. The problem with this is you need a series of timers to make sure the system never doses the kelk until after the kelk's settled out, otherwise you end up dosing the undesirable slurry. This can certainly be done, but has a lot of opportunity to fail, and frankly, the saturated kelk is really hard on the pumps. Two Little Fishies also makes a small mixer which works off the feed pump. This certainly works, but you get what you pay for, so don't be shocked if the stir mechanism clogs, and finding the right flow balance where it's properly mixing but not sending slurry into the tank can be somewhat challenging. Frankly, I also don't think it holds enough kelk washer powder to be particularly useful. To maintain full saturation, most tank owners would have to fill it pretty frequently. The type I've used in the past and recommend if you're in the market for a kelk reactor is known as a stirrer, which uses a slow-moving bar at the bottom to keep the kelk constantly mixed and fully saturated. The stir bar moves slow enough that the slurry stays at the bottom and the saturated kelk solution moves to the top. When you pump in new fresh water, it enters at the bottom and has to pass through and mingle with the constantly rotating slurry at the bottom of the reactor. As long as you pump water through the reactor slowly and in periodic bursts, the slurry stays at the bottom. Aquamedic makes a pair that we most commonly recommend, and in most cases, we find that investing in the larger of the two is wise because a large capacity makes it much easier to prevent the slurry from reaching the top and being dosed into the tank. That wraps up today's 52 FAQ. If you're interested in learning more about Kelkwasser in general and how it works, check out week 30, Kelkwasser, an all-in-one calcium, alkalinity, and pH supplement. If you found this valuable and you want to see more, give us a quick thumbs up and subscribe. See you soon with the next 52 FAQ.